It's hard to believe that someone like yourself, and whether you like it or not, you are a living legend. It's hard to believe that you should feel unable to do a good performance when you've been lauded for doing that performance before.
Oh, I think that's what makes it frightening, because if you have a big success, then you feel people are expecting so much. I mean, if you have a failure, you can only really get better. But if something's been a big success, then you can fall down, and I think that's why I get nervous.
Do you like being a legend, or do you
recognise
that you
are? I don't have any sense of it, really. It doesn't feel like anything at all. I'm just surprised when people say those things. But
do you think you'd be disappointed if people didn't expect a legend?
No, I don't think I would think about it at all. Mm-hmm. I'm usually surprised people recognise me or people say these sort of marvellous things. But I'm always a little bit surprised because I don't feel it.
Do you keep a press book?
No, I gave up keeping press cuttings long, long ago, and I usually don't read them.
Uh-huh. Why was that? What made you decide not to keep them?
Well, again, because I think that it's bad to read reviews, especially good ones, mm-hmm. because they make me terribly nervous. I don't mind so much reading a bad review in a way, because I think, oh, well, that's what he thinks, I'll show him.
Yeah.
But if you read something saying that you're incredible and marvellous and this, that and the other, it gives you a rather helpless feeling that you're not like that, and how can you live up to it?
You must spend a lot of time then not reading all your reviews, yes. Because most of them are like that. But when you get a bad review...
Sometimes they're quite bad.
When you get a bad criticism, does that make you feel, damn it, what does he know about it? You know, I was slogging my guts out on that stage and I get this kind of thing.
Well, not really, no. I get upset when I see bad reviews for younger dancers, because I think if I will persist in dancing so long, I can expect any kind of a notice, so I don't I don't bother about that. But I do get upset sometimes, the things they say about young dancers, when I know how hard it is for them and how much they're struggling and how they're giving everything they have, and then somebody comes along with a stroke of a pen and annihilates them. And I think it's very mean to do those kind of things.
What about your career and your marriage? How have you managed to mix those two together?
Well, they just go together. No, I suppose so. They just do. I mean, somehow it's all right.
Does your husband go with you wherever he can or whenever he can? Or?
Well, quite often we manage to have a reason to be in the same place. So we do spend a great deal of time together.
Mm.
And then I think he's just a very special person, so it's all right, whatever he does. It's always all right.
Then, Margot, you have said, I was very lucky, I started at the right time and had marvellous chances, and I had good conditions to work in. It would be much harder starting now. Is that really true? Because I don't think you really had such an easy start.
Oh, I think I did. I just went on the stage when I was 14 and I was dancing right away, and I had an enormous opportunities to dance principal roles, solo roles, ballerina roles. I would still be in the ballet school now when I was dancing the whole of Swan Lake.
But that's not easy. I mean, that can't be an easy start. That's very hard, enormously hard work.
Yes, but I think it's easier to get started on it early. Because if one waits until you're 18, you graduate from the school, and then you're maybe 22 before you finally do Swan Lake, look how much more time you have to think about it and worry about it. And if you're pushed on doing those things when you're very young, you can say to yourself, well, nobody expects much of me because I'm so young and I'll do my best. But